Don't look now, it's a taiga. No, that's a tiger. Taiga, a giant snowy forest where you can play the best game of hide and seek ever, following animal tracks and exploring hidden paths. In this special place, you'll find tall trees, frosty air, and creatures as big and imposing as a giant moose and as small and gentle as a snowshoe hare. And yes, it's even home to the beautiful Siberian tiger. This is the Boreal Forest, a vast and unique biome that stretches across the northern parts of the globe. It's an evergreen forest, home to towering trees like spruce, fir, and pine. This special place experiences long, cold winters and short, mild summers, creating a perfect place to live for a distinct set of plants and animals. As we explore the Boreal Forest, we'll discover how its inhabitants survive in the harsh climate and learn about the important role this biome plays in our planet's health and balance. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. What makes a boreal forest a biome? Well, ecologists decided to split up the Earth this way into 11 types of places. This makes our world easier to study and understand. A biome is a large part of the world that has a specific climate along with distinct types of plants and animals that are well suited for living there. The taiga is the largest land biome on Earth. It stretches across the northern parts of North America, Europe, and Asia, just below the Arctic Circle. The landscape is covered by towering green trees that go on for miles and miles. I mean, hey, it's the biggest land biome for a reason. Beneath these towering trees, the forest floor is covered with a thick layer of moss and fallen needles. This environment is home to a variety of animals. We'll meet a few of them later. The taiga experiences heavy snowfall during winter, and in the warmer months, many beautiful lakes, rivers, and wetlands can be found within it. The soil in the boreal forest is often thin and poor in nutrients because the cold slows down the process of decomposition, meaning that dead plants and animals take a long time to break down. Another notable feature is the presence of permafrost in some areas, which is a layer of soil that remains frozen throughout the year. Imagine what it would be like to start a garden with frozen soil. Yeah, pretty tough if not impossible. The fact that some plants can grow, especially into towering trees in this part of the world, is a very impressive feat in itself. The most common trees are evergreen trees like spruce, fir, and pine. Evergreen means that the trees stay green all year long. These trees have needles instead of broad leaves, which helps them hold on to water and stay green all year round, even in the freezing winter. These trees are also very tall and grow close together. This creates a thick canopy, allowing only a little bit of sunlight to reach the forest floor. Long story short, it can make the forest floor even colder than it already was. Besides trees, there are also many shrubs, like blueberry and cranberry bushes, which grow close to the ground. The forest floor is covered with a soft green carpet of mosses, which can survive in the shady, damp conditions under the trees. Lichens, which are a mix of fungi and algae, also grow on tree trunks and rocks. All these plants have special ways to deal with the cold, like having thick, waxy coatings on their leaves to prevent freezing, or growing close to the ground to stay warmer. Enjoying the video so far? Learning a lot? Socratica Kids is an educational nonprofit, and our smart, fun videos are possible because of people like you. Donate today and help us get started on our next video series all about the animals who live in these special biomes. Here's a little preview. So, who exactly is living in this chilly, forested land? Some of the most common animals include moose, wolves, bears, and lynx. Moose are the largest animals in the boreal forest, and they use their long legs to move through deep snow and their strong jaws to eat twigs and bark in the winter. Wolves live in packs and are excellent hunters, often working together to catch prey like deer and rabbits. Bears, like the brown bear, spend the summer eating as much as they can to build up fat, and then they hibernate in the winter to stay warm and save energy. Hibernation is when animals either significantly slow down their movements or go to sleep for large chunks of the year in order to save energy and avoid the colder months. We can't forget the wild cats, like the big Siberian tiger, but also the smaller stealthy lynx. They have big furry paws that act like snowshoes, helping them walk on top of the snow to hunt for small animals. The boreal forest is also full of birds, especially in the summer when many fly here to raise their chicks. Birds like the spruce grouse, great gray owl, and crossbill can be found here. These birds are able to live in the forest by having strong beaks for cracking seeds and silent flight for sneaking up on prey. Lastly, insects play a big role in the boreal forest too. Mosquitoes, ants, and beetles might seem small, but they are very important. They help break down dead plants and animals, turning them into nutrients that help the forest grow. Some insects are also food for birds and other animals. Circle of life. In the boreal forest, all plants and animals are connected in a complex web influenced by their environment. This is called the ecosystem, and it includes food chains and food webs that show who eats what to survive. Ecologists describe a food chain as a simple way to see how energy moves from one living thing to another. For example, a plant like a blueberry bush gets energy from the sun. A hare might eat the blueberries, and then a lynx might eat the hare. This shows how energy moves from the sun to the plant to the herbivore, the hare, to the carnivore, the lynx. But in the real world, food chains are just a smaller part of food webs because animals eat lots of different things. For example, the lynx might also eat birds, and the hare might eat other plants besides blueberries. This creates a web of connections where everything is linked together. Ecologists also pay attention to the predator-prey relationships in the boreal forest. Predators like wolves, lynx, and owls hunt other animals for food. Their prey might be other animals like mice, hares, or deer. Some predators even hunt other predators. These relationships help keep the population of animals in balance. If there are too many prey animals, they might eat too many plants. But if there are too many predators, they might not find enough food to survive. Would you like to call this biome home? If you could be any animal in the boreal forest, what would it be? Would it be a moose strolling on the forest floor? Or a bird flying high above the canopy of trees? Or maybe it would be a bear who gets to snuggle up in the cold winter months for hibernation. You can see that in addition to being beautiful, the boreal forest can teach us a lot about how we all live together here on planet Earth. Are you interested in learning more about the plants and animals that live in other parts of the world? Be sure to check out the rest of our video series about biomes on the Socratica Kids YouTube channel. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you. Linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.